Hey guys, Matt here from mksmarthouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to connect the Google Home to your OpenAB 2 system. I love the Google Home and think it's an awesome device that makes controlling smart devices really easily with voice control. You can be in another room and yell to Google and tell it to turn on a device for you. In this video, we will be connecting Google Home to our OpenAB 2 system so it can control our OpenAB item. For this video, we are going to need a device running iOS or Android, a computer running Windows or macOS, an OpenAB server, and the star of the show, a Google Home device. The links to all the devices, parts, and guides mentioned are in the video description. Speaking of links in the description, follow at MKSmartHouse on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat, because those are the places where I give sneak peeks on when videos are releasing, and also where I ask for your input on topics and future videos. Lately, I have also been posting things that only a true smart home enthusiast would appreciate. For this guide, I'm going to assume you already have the Google Home installed and it is running perfectly using the setup instructions Google provides, and you can control it and access it from the Google Home app. I'm also going to assume that you have an items file and a rules file. If you do not, then go take a look at my video where I explain how to set up the configuration files in OpenAB. I will not be making two separate videos using Mac and PC because the process is really similar. The only difference is that on Mac you use Terminal to SSH, and on PC or Windows you would use PuTTY. If you are a smart home enthusiast like me and want to show that you're an elite member of the smart home community, then check out Smart House Society for premium quality hoodies, shirts, and hats. Supplies are limited, so check out the link in the description now. The first thing we have to do is SSH into the OpenAB server. I recommend having my website guide open when you do this, so that way you can just copy and paste commands. Now type in sudo nano /etc/openab2/items/home.items and press enter. Now we're going to add the tags that Google Home supports to the item. The tags go right before the bind and config. The Google Home supports the following tags: switchable, this tag is used with the switch item type, dimmer item type, color item type, as well as the roller shutter item type, but you would not use this for a light. That is what the next one is for. Lighting, this tag is used for lights with the switch item type, dimmer item type, and color item type. Current temperature, this tag would be used for a device that reports temperature and has the number item type. Thermostat, this tag is used with an item that has a group item type and the following devices in the group: current temperature, target temperature, HomeKit heating cooling. I personally do not use the tags associated with thermostat and have never used them, but if you want more information on them, check it out on the GitHub. Link is on my website, which is in the description. I just use the lighting and switchable one. In the future, we may be using the current temperature one. All right, let's take a look at my items file because I've already put in the tags. As you can see, I put the switchable tag next to the items that are the switch item type but are not lights. I also put the switchable tag into the garage door shutter dummy item because they are of the roller shutter item type. Here is the complete item. It's on the screen now or on my website. I created a dummy switch for the garage doors because Chamberlain MyQ does not like the command it receives when the Google Home talks to it. So I created the dummy roller shutters as sort of a middleman to handle a request. I will talk more about this later. You can also see I use the lighting tag for the two light switches. I also use the lighting tag for my color LED strips. If you guys have any questions on these tags, leave them in the comments because chances are somebody else probably has it too. Or over on mksmarthouse.com/forum. Anyway, once all your tags are in place, press Ctrl X, then Y and Enter to save. Now we have to address the roller shutter items because when Google Home sends a command, it uses percents. Let's fix it. This step is optional and only if you have a roller shutter item that needs on and off or up and down instead of percents. Type in sudo nano /etc/openab2/rules/home.rules and press Enter. Then type in the following. On the screen now or on my website. I pasted in twice and modified it because I have two garage doors. All this rule is doing is taking the percents from the dummy items and then either sending the on or off command to the device. If your device requires up or down, then change the on to up and off to down. Now press Ctrl X and then Y and Enter to save. Great, the items are now done. So the next thing we are going to do is connect the Google Home. So grab your mobile device that already has the Home app installed and open the app. First, press the three lines at the top left to bring up the menu. Then press on Home Control. In the bottom right, click on the plus sign. It will bring up a list of smart devices you can add to the Google Home. Scroll down and press on Open Hub. It will open up a web browser page. So type in your myopenhub.org username and password and press sign in. It will load a new page. Press allow. Once it is finished, it will say something like authorized or connected. After, it will show you all the items it found. If you want, you can go through and organize the devices by room. Then hit done. That's it. The Google Home now has access to all your devices and you control them with voice commands. Let's test it. Okay, Google, turn on MK Lite.
Sure, turning the MK Lite on.
Okay, Google, set garage door 1 to 0.
You got it, setting garage door 1 brightness to 0%.
Okay, Google, turn on sprinkler zone 1.
Okay, turning on sprinkler zone 1.
Okay, Google, set desk LED strip to blue.
You got it, changing the desk LED strip to blue.
Okay, Google, set JK blinds to 100.
Sure, setting the JK blinds brightness to 100%.
The device is connected and working. Now we can control our OpenHAB items with voice commands. That concludes this complete guide to connecting the Google Home to OpenHAB 2. In the description, you will find links to all the parts and devices used in the video, as well as links to mksmarts.com/shop, where I have a wide range of smart home kits that you can put together, such as blinds, LED strips, sprinkler systems, and door sensors. All right, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, or head over to mksmarts.com/forum. Goodbye.